Terry Ryken, Realtor at Sotheby's, proudly presents Ken Boxer Live.
Hi, this is Anson Williams, and you're looking at Ken Boxer Live on TVSB with Tai Babilonia.
From the American Riviera in Santa Barbara, California, it's Ken Boxer Live with your host, Ken Boxer, and co-host, two-time Olympian Tai Babilonia. Please welcome Ken and Tai.
Thank you so very much. Wow. Thank you. Oh my God.
Wow.
What a group. This is one of the largest audience we've had in a long time. Yeah. Probably the largest.
I think so.
Well,
I think
welcome.
You're right.
We gotta welcome the people. It's Ken Boxer Live. You're watching a fantastic half-hour show of entertainment with some special guests tonight. And I want to introduce always my lovely and very talented co-host, the two-time Olympian, five-time national champion, as well as a world champion, and now being inducted into the Ice Skating Hall of Fame.
Wow.
Tai Babilonia, yeah. Let's give it up.
Thank you. Thank you, Ken.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Gratitude.
You know, I learned today, if you can believe it, Tai's son, Scout, and I just had his 21st birthday today. Happy birthday, Scout, and you don't look like you could have somebody.
I'm so not prepared for this. I can't wrap my brain around that Scout is 21 years old. Happy tears, I'm so proud of him. He's my heart, he's my biggest supporter, and happy birthday, Scout.
Happy birthday,
Scout.
All right. Well, Tai, who do we have on the show?
Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. He is a TV icon. He was a star of the hit show Happy Days back in the 70s. He's a director, he's an entrepreneur, he's an author of a brand new cookbook that we'll talk about later. Tonight we have Mr. Anson Williams
in
the studio.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So don't go away. We'll be right back with Anson Williams.
Yay.
Ken Boxer Live, brought to you in part by Marjoram Wine Company, handcrafted wines and committed to excellence. Harborview Inn. Welcome to Santa Barbara's premier four-diamond luxury boutique oceanfront hotel. The Wine Cask, serving seasonal California cuisine with Santa Barbara's largest wine list. Now back to Ken Boxer Live.
Wow. Thank you.
Love that.
We are back.
Energy.
With us tonight is the accomplished actor, director, producer, singer, and cook, Anson Williams. Anson's best known for his character Potsie in the still very popular television series Happy Days. And now, Anson has a new book that's about to be released called The Perfect Portion Cookbook. Ladies and gentlemen, let's now welcome Anson Williams.
I don't know, was that hiccup off one of the recipes?
It's like,
oh my God,
was it
too spicy?
My throat got
dry.
What
did I do wrong?
I'm so happy you're here. We're so happy and delighted.
I'm glad I'm here too.
What don't you do, Skinny?
I just totally rigmaroled my...
But you're a pro, this is what you do.
I have someone else usually do this.
You're a pro.
No, hang on.
Okay.
Hello,
we can still, let's
Starship Enterprise.
My audio tech's going. Oh
I've got
no!
He's going What's crazy going right now. Wait, I actually can fix this.
Can
you help me?
This is called entrepreneur.
Hold on, right here.
Can fix a bad situation.
No, there you go. On that side.
Do you notice the calm?
That's right.
You got to be calm in any situation. Oh my God!
That's it.
I can't. Right. See.
You got it.
You got it. Yay!
That's it.
Anson.
Anson. Hi, I'm Anson.
This is not the first time you're in Santa Barbara, right?
I'm a Southern California native, so I've been up to Santa Barbara, you know, numerous times. And actually would love to live here.
Me too.
You too, right?
Yes.
But it's just a little inconvenient for what I have to do, so I can't. But hopefully one day you know, I'll be up here.
Yeah, let's hear it. Let's come on.
I love Santa Barbara.
I do too. Are you kidding me?
Santa Barbara?
It's lovely.
Awesome. The world can learn from Santa Barbara. You talk about,
wow.
I'm serious.
It's like a commercial.
No, I'm serious.
No, I know, it's lovely.
The architecture, the people, multicultural.
The boyfriend.
You know, the boyfriend, right? Her boyfriend, right here. Can we get a close-up? Can we get a close-up here? Where are you going? You're going to dinner where? I was telling him, well, there it goes again.
Oh, no.
Oh my gosh, I don't know what,
it's
this
okay.
is like, really?
It's fine.
It's going to be a show about...
Is it still working, though?
Are we just going to go with this?
No, I'm going to... No, it's good.
Actually, this is very good.
Is it okay?
Flaws make stars are going to be so huge. Hang on. There we go again.
Okay.
Hang on.
This is reality.
Maybe we can have one of our audio people come.
This is so good. No, I can do it. I can do it.
So you're a director, and you have all the angles.
Doing it.
Hang
on.
How many years?
There we go.
So
there we go. Now watch.
You got it. Try it again.
You're so active.
No, all I have to do is... It's the portion control.
No, what it is, it's the body control I don't have. I'm going like this. And
Okay, that's good. Okay.
Hi, Anson. I'm Anson.
You want to start again, we can start again.
Yeah.
No. Do you want me to, or is it funny?
I like it. It's perfect.
Everyone's giving it...
Yeah.
Now we're getting like,
now we're getting
now we're actually, okay, here it is. It's going to be audience choice.
How
many hands to start again? How many hands to keep going?
Let's see.
We're keeping going.
Let me ask you, it's all in editing.
Editing. Yep.
What do you want to do?
It's real.
Want to do?
It is real.
Don't get too technical.
I know.
Okay.
It's cable.
Let's see.
This will go so viral, you have no idea.
This is good. We got the okay.
Yeah.
I was told that you were on the track team in high school. Yes?
No, I was never on the track team in high school.
My research said...
Your research is wrong.
Were you an athlete? Football team.
I got the wrong sport.
I was second string. I got just enough to letter. I never forget. I was like 149 pounds. And for some reason, I went on to varsity instead of like B team. So now, if anyone knows defensive end, you're supposed to be big. And I'm this guy like this, and Bayless, who was first string, was like 6 feet four. And when he was tired, they threw me in. So at the end of the game, you know, everyone had these, you know, dark, you know, white uniforms with dirt on the front. I was totally white with dirt on the back. Bam!
Oh, no.
Bam! And I kept thinking, if I let her, I can get a date. If I let her, I can get a date.
Oh, see.
That was my football career. I let her.
Did you get the date?
I didn't get a date. It actually took happy days to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, and then he started acting.
Let me do that. Thank you.
It's still there.
I didn't lose it.
You're such a pro.
So... You had acting in high school. You must have had some training in high school. You got the bug in high school for acting?
Actually, you know, I came from a very lower middle class family, you know, three bedrooms, one bathroom, $100 in the bank, a number in the world. I had this desire to sing in high school and I or perform. I didn't really know how to deal with it. And it's not something you like talked about. So it wasn't until I was out of high school that I started pursuing, you know, entertainment. And when I told my dad and my mom, I was kicked out of the house. Because they came out of the Depression. No, they came out of the Depression.
Right.
You're going to be a teacher, you're going to be this. Oh. I'm going to perform.
Something
stable. Get out. Just get out. And come back when you're sane. Well, and honestly, thinking back, they're right. What are the odds? What were the odds? But I started standing in lines for, you know, equity. You know, equity shows. You stand in the non-equity line. And, you know, if you, I lucked
you
out. I lucked
any
out.
Acting classes and work on the stage?
Well, that's what I was standing in line for. I got an apprentice.
I got an apprentice job
in summer stock.
Got it.
And from that, got my equity card.
Yes.
And then one thing led to another.
Auditions.
I used to just go to talent nights around L.A. singing badly.
Okay.
No, they would give you, you know, you have this little sheet music way back then. We're talking way back then. Mm-hmm. And there'd be this piano player that hates you, didn't even know you.
Funny.
And the cigarette smoke is like coughing you out. And it was Jack Callies by CBS. Uh-huh. It was a little club in Santa Monica. And you go up there and you go, you coach the blues right out of the way. Next,
whatever. It was like an off, you know, and that you learn to be better than
absolutely.
Bad, right?
Yeah.
When did you know you had the talent to go out and audition?
Do I?
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
In fact, we have a clip. Give us the lead into this first clip we're about to see.
Oh, is that the Happy Days pilot?
Yes.
Oh, but how many of you know there were two Happy Days pilots? The first one didn't sell. The first one was more like a Summer of 42, kind of softer, new television set, coming to the family, you know. They aired on Love American Style. It wasn't shot for Love American Style, but they aired on Love American Style, and it didn't sell. A year later, American Graffiti came out, and Grease was on Broadway, and they decided to do another pilot. Thank God, because the first pilot didn't have Fonzie, didn't have Ralphie, didn't have Tom Bosley, didn't have Aaron Moran.
Wow.
Someone very, very important in my life told me years ago in high school, Anson, there's better ways to get there. And this was a big lesson for me, because there were better ways to get there for Happy Days. If we would have sold, if this pilot would have sold, I wouldn't be here today. Let's look at this.
So let's watch.
Anson
Williams, ladies and gentlemen, let's watch.
Today's a big day. We're going to be the first family on the block to get a television set. My sister has to tell everybody, but I only told my best friend, Potsie.
Open the door, Richard.
Hey, Potsie. My mom didn't like you climbing through there.
Then it's good she didn't see me. Your television get here?
Tonight. I got to study now.
Yeah, me too. Here's Spanish test tomorrow.
I know. I don't know why I ever took Spanish.
Lame brain. It takes Spanish to pick up Spanish girls. French is for French girls, and Latin. Latin's stupid. What are you going to pick up with Latin? A nun?
You're a jaboni. You take Latin to become a doctor.
Arthur Visseltier says that Mrs. Bernardo's built better than Mrs. Nofziger.
I never thought about it.
You're full of bull. That's all everybody thinks about in social studies.
Do you think maybe there's something wrong with us?
Yeah. You having people over to see the fight on television?
I guess so.
Well, you can invite somebody, can't you?
Sure. I'll ask my father if you can come.
Hey, you know, television's gonna revolutionize.
Yeah?
It's a great way to get chicks. You invite them over for a little television. Turn the lights down low. And then grab them right in the middle of Kukla, Fran, and Ollie.
Girls will be wise to that.
So what?
That was 1972.
So after this, you had to audition again.
Yes.
For the next pilot.
Yes.
Okay, take us through that.
Well, I was doing a Hallmark Hall of Fame special called Lisa Bright and Dark years ago. I had this great career. I'd play the concerned boyfriend. There'd be like five pages of like a big scene, and I'd have five lines. You know, like one a page?
Right.
So I was the reactor of television.
Okay.
Now they all be talking
about
it. I'm going.
Aww.
And it's coming. I understand. So when I had one of those parts paying Kay Lenz's boyfriend on this show, and I get this call saying, hey, they're going to do another Happy Days pilot. I go, great. When do we start? And they say, well, they want you and Ron to screen test. They think you might be too old. What, I have to audition for the part I created? Yep.
Wow.
So we did. We actually had to go back, screen test, and I won't go through this whole story, but after a whole series of events, we did get the parts again. And it's funny, Don Most auditioned for Potsie. John Travolta.
Oh, really?
John Travolta auditioned for Potsie.
No way.
He did. He did, because he played this kind of nerdy character in Grease.
Right. Oh, that's right.
At the time.
Yeah.
Yeah. I saved his career. He didn't get it.
That's true.
You know,
I love that.
Because he's so much better actor than I could ever be. But Donnie Most, who played Ralph, auditioned for Potsie. They liked him so much, they created the character of Ralph for
Interesting.
Him. And then Harold Gould, who played the first Mr. C, wasn't available. Tom Bosley came in. Aaron Moran played Kaylin's sister on this Hallmark Hall of Fame special I did. They wanted to recast the sister. I recommended her. She auditioned with everyone else, and Aaron ended up getting the part.
Anson, how did the popularity of the Fonz affect you in your role?
It affected me tremendously. It bought me a house. Are you kidding me? Henry, go, wow. Buddy. Go.
And he created that character.
Oh, no, that Henry Winkler?
Yes.
That character was not written. It was what was written was a stereotypical kind of biker guy. Mm-hmm. And it ended up being between Mickey Dolenz and Henry Winkler.
I love from all the these monkeys. Tidbits. Wow. Yeah.
And Henry just came in with this whole different interpretation. So when you see Fonzie, Henry 100% created that part. That was not written. He's just brilliant genius. And because of him, we're here today. I mean, he literally became the number one star in the world. But he also had the humility and the camaraderie to go with it, which is, you know, we're very lucky.
Did you realize during Happy Days how huge the show was becoming?
We didn't realize at the beginning.
Right.
You know, we're kids. What did we know?
Yeah.
But, you know, after a while, it was quite apparent. There were three networks at the time. That was it. So our average audience was 60 million people a week. And then it was 60 million people a week. And then also reruns during the day. So 1/4 the country watched you on Tuesday night, and the rest watched you during the day. So it's funny, I direct all these kids today, like I directed Secret Life for years, and they get all crazy with 2.5 million people watching my show. I go, great, that's big time.
You even had, you had John Lennon and Elvis Presley watching.
Well, John Lennon surprised us on the set one day in 1974 when we first started with his son Julian. And John spent the whole day with us. And this is before we were in front of a live audience. It was shot like a movie.
Right.
And we got to spend the whole day with this genius. What a kind, kind.
Did you know he was coming, though?
Had no idea.
So he just walked in.
I know. He just walked in. I happened to notice him by the big tin of bad coffee. I went back to the cast going, this is a guy with this kid. The guy looks like John Lennon. And Donnie Most goes, yeah, John Lennon came to here to spend the day with us. He did.
Wow.
And he spent the whole day with us.
Elvis?
Elvis I met in a parking lot in Monroe, Louisiana. You want to know the story?
Yes, yeah. It's still on. You're on.
Am I on?
You're on.
I felt something go, I'm going, it's gone again. No, but I was doing a telethon. And one part of the parking lot was a little television station for the telethon.
Right.
The other end of the parking lot was the Monroe Civic Center, and Elvis was doing a concert. And I won't say, but ABCD, I was able to go across and meet him when he came out the stage door before he went to his car. And it was quite an amazing conversation.
Love that.
He came there. He came out specifically for this young boy who had cerebral palsy. And Red, who was kind of a famous friend of his, met this young boy and his mom at a restaurant and invited them to meet Elvis as he came out the stage door.
Wow.
And they were my sponsors for the day at this telethon. So they asked me if I wanted to go along. So I just kind of tagged along with them. And Elvis came out, and it was a couple of years before he passed away. So he wasn't looking very good.
Right.
But his kindness is unbelievable. He had the scarf on, he comes out, he goes to this young boy, he made this young boy feel like a king. Put the scarf around him, talked, really connected with this boy, made him feel like $1 million, and he came to me and he said, really like the way you sing. Watched me?
Oh my goodness.
Now I'm like, turned out that a very important part of my life, it was in high school when I had very little confidence and I was working as an assistant janitor at this department store, and my boss was the head janitor was a man by the name of Willie Turner, who was African American, and not well educated, and he probably most people wouldn't look at twice. I would not be here without Willie Turner. He called his janitorial room the talk room, and here I was, this young, unconfident kid. I knew everything I did wrong, nothing I did right. Mm-hmm. He was the first man to talk to me and not at me. And he helped me find me. In the years I worked as that job, I walked out of Leonard's department store moving forward. If it wasn't for Willie, I wouldn't be here. He gave me the power to move forward. Somehow we talked about this, and Elvis said, and no one knows the story, he said, I had a Willie. He said, I went out of high school. He said, I'm working at this electronics factory on the line. I think people know he worked at this place on the line. There was a man next to him that was African American. And Elvis said that he would just sing while he was doing. And this man gave him the confidence to record.
Great story.
If it wasn't for him, he said, I wouldn't have gone in and recorded for my mom. I never would have been at Sun Records. It never would have happened. This unsung hero. And no one knows that story.
It's a great story. Thanks for sharing that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can you stay in touch with?
Before we get to that, we want to now go see your singing on the video, so people can see your singing.
Uh-oh.
Elvis watched it.
Uh-oh, that's amazing. I don't know.
Anson Williams singing. Let's watch.
Well, let's try playing Splish Blast. That'll really get him. Okay, guys?
All right.
Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Splish Splash, I was taking a bath. Long about a Saturday night. A rubber dub, just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was all right. Well, I stepped out the tub, put my feet on the floor. I wrapped the towel around me and I opened the door. And then I splish splash, I jumped back in the bath. Well, how was I to know there was a party going on? There was a splishing and a splashing, reeling with the feeling, rolling and a strolling, moving and a grooving. Hey, yeah!
Long about a Saturday night, rub-a-dub, just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was all right. Well, I stepped out the tub, put my feet on the stepped, put a towel around me, and I
opened the door.
And then I jumped back in the bath. Well, how was I to know there was a party going? Yes, we're talking about this.
I love it.
Okay, very quickly. I know you don't have a lot of time.
Let's talk about this book.
Oh, that.
The Perfect Portion Cookbook.
Yes. The Perfect Portion Cookbook.
I love this.
Well, this is, you know, I've been in the product business about 20 years. We create products that are problem solvers. And I had a personal problem like 24 to 30 pounds ago.
You look amazing.
There it is.
Us boomers are happening, baby. We climb the mountain. We're moving forward. We teach the youngins. And I'll tell you, but you got to feel good.
You got to hold your mic now.
Hold this.
You got to look good.
Just hold it.
This thing, you know, honestly, I swear this mic, excuse me, this mic is going to be a spinoff, man. I've never
it's
done
gonna
a show.
It's going to get its own show.
No, I've never done a show in 40 years where a mic got so much attention. Anyway.
Tell us about the book.
No, yes. Anyway, the book. So anyway.
And the weight loss.
And well, what happened was, anyway, cut whatever, you know, you're on set, you're eating craft service, you're over, and I'm going, I can't live like this, but I don't want to diet. I want to eat what I love and not overeat. So going to the marketplace, you know, you see all those 100-calorie snacks, right? Is everyone 100-calorie this, 100-calorie that? And I'm thinking, why can't we eat the foods we love, make the recipes a little healthier? French toast, lasagna, chili, chicken pot pies, key lime pies, pizza. Why can't we have what we love and make each little portion a little bigger, but have it in exact 100-calorie portions? So if you say, oh, I want a 300-calorie portion of chicken pot pie, it's, oh, that's easy. 1, 2, 3. It doesn't taste like cardboard, like all those other systems out there, and you don't have to be a physicist to figure out the damn calorie count.
Right.
Right? So my business partner, Joanna Cannell, and I, we didn't know enough about food. I had this idea. We went to Robert Warden and Donna Mulgove, who are experts at QVC. Robert's like huge. They said, this is great. We partnered up. And together, mostly with their expertise, we created the Perfect Portion Cookbook using the perfect 100-calorie count.
Right.
150 of the most delicious recipes known to humankind, all your favorite comfort foods, in exact 100-calorie portions. So if you have an 1,850-calorie day, you can't eat it all. I can have French toast for breakfast, I can have chicken pot pie for lunch, and I can have lasagna for dinner, salad, appetizer, and 3 snacks.
And look at you.
And look at me. I have never eaten so well. I've never, no, seriously, my body's like I'm 30. And it's all from portion control, but satisfying yourself. I don't need to eat more because I'm satisfied, and I'm not. How many of you guys have been on diets?
We got about 30 seconds.
We have 30 seconds. Perfect portion cookbook. February 7th, QVC. Go to the perfectportion.com. Theperfectportion.com, and you'll save money.
Anson, thank you.
One more time. Splish, splash, I was taking a bath. Long about a Saturday night, everybody. Rub a dub, just relaxing in the tub. Thinking everything was all right. Well, I stepped out the tub, put my towel around me, and then splish, splash. Jump back in the bath. Well, how was I to know there was a party going on? Yeah, go, baby. Oh, da, 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 da,
da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da, da,
da,
da, da, da,
Ken Boxer Live is brought to you by the following sponsors. Terry Ryken Realtor at Sotheby's, your broker with a personal touch. Palazzo Restaurant, where people don't leave hungry or thirsty. Harborview Inn, welcome to Santa Barbara's premier four-diamond luxury boutique oceanfront hotel. Wendy Foster, Santa Barbara and Montecito's premier clothing store. The Eagle Inn, a family-owned hotel near the beach in Santa Barbara. Via Rosa Inn, let us pamper you in international style. La Quinta Inn and Suites, conveniently located in downtown Santa Barbara. And by Taffy's Pizza, delivery, pickup, or dine-in. Marjoram Wine Company, handcrafted wines and committed to excellence. Woody's Bodacious Barbecue, voted best barbecue in Santa Barbara for over 30 years. Santa Barbara Bar, finally, nutritious, tastes great. Country Catering, Meat Market, and Deli. Their food not only fills your plate, it nourishes the soul. The Wine Cask, serving seasonal California cuisine with Santa Barbara's largest wine list. Jack's Bagels and Bistro, serving the very best food in a friendly and relaxed atmosphere. Quality food and genuine drinks. Jill's Place, where the locals go to eat. Lido's Takeout, serving the best Mexican food for over 30 years. Paul Mitchell, the school, dedicated to helping students achieve their goals. Perfect Computers, since 1990. Ice and Paradise, fun for the entire family. The Santa Barbara Access Card. The Ken Boxer Live musical theme by Mr. Michael J. Leslie. From all of us at Ken Boxer Live, I'm Baron Ron Heron. Good night, everyone.